Hello and welcome to this session of class 9 mathematics, and I am your Anu for maxpool.1. Now today we are going to introduce a new chapter, that is chapter 4, linear equations in two variables. Now before getting into the topic, now let us see what we have done before. We know variables and constants, isn't it? See, variables like literals, we have literals to denote variables, that is, it can take any number of values. I can assign any value to x, so it is called as variable, whereas a number, it is called as constant, whose value doesn't change, isn't it? Then next to it, we saw how to combine these variables and constants, and those are called terms or expressions. And these algebraic expressions, when they are equated to some other value, or if they are equated to zero, then that is called an equation, isn't it? So in that equation, if you have only one type of variable, it is called an equation. It's an equation in just a single variable. And if the degree of the equation, degree means the maximum power of the variable, is called the degree of the equation, isn't it? So if the degree is, the maximum degree is 1, then that equation or that polynomial is called a linear polynomial, and we have studied all those things, isn't it? Now in this class we are going to read about the linear equations in two variables. So what do you mean by linear equation? Where the degree is 1, the degree of the equation or degree of the polynomial is 1, but it has two variables. Unlike one variable we had before, it has two variables, namely x and y, where a and b are constants. Okay, so that is what we are going to study about in this chapter. So y is equal to ax plus b will be your general format, or we can generalize even further, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. So what is this? This is an example of a linear equation in two variables. This is just an example of linear equation in two variable where it gives the value of y. Y is equal to ax plus b represents there is some value for y when we substitute values for x. We'll come to that later on. But we have the general expression of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, or ax plus by is equal to c is also a general notation for linear equations in two variables. Do you understand? Where a, b, c and constants, and a should not be equal to 0 and b should not be equal to 0. So what is the value for x and y? Now what values can x and y take? How will the values of x and y will be? Okay, so these are the questions which arises. Now x and y, we know they are variables. They can take any number of any values can be assigned to x and y since they are variables. So x is a real number. We can take x and y are real numbers, but a should not be equal to 0 and b should not be equal to 0. So imagine if a is equal to 0. If a is equal to 0, what happens? This term diminishes and we get just by is equal to c, and this reduces to a single variable. Linear equation in single variable. There is no point in understanding linear equations in two variables when a is equal to 0, isn't it? Similarly, when b is equal to 0, the equation reduces to ax is equal to c, and this also becomes linear equation in single variable. Isn't it? So we make sure that a is not equal to 0 and b is not equal to 0 when we study about linear equations in two variables. Do you understand? So now after seeing the general format of linear equations, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Now let us take an example like 7x minus y is equal to 5. So arbitrarily, I am taking some value 7x minus 7, some equation like 7x minus y is equal to 5. This is a linear equation in two variable, isn't it? So what happens when I substitute some value for x? Say when I substitute x is equal to 0. When I have x is equal to 0, what happens? 7 into 0 minus y is equal to 5, which denotes minus y is equal to 5 or y is equal to minus 5. So you see, when x is equal to 0, 5 is equal to minus 5, isn't it? Now the next substitution can be when x is equal to 1. So what happens when x is equal to 1? See, 7 into 1 minus y is equal to 5. That becomes y is equal to 5 minus 7, or y is equal to 2. So when x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2. So likewise, we can substitute any number of values for x and y. That is, x can be assigned, y can be assigned any number of values. If x is assigned a value, we get a corresponding value for y. If y is assigned a value, we get a corresponding value for x. So what does this values for x and y mean? So what does this value for x and y mean? Whatever we substitute the value for x, we get a value, correspondingly we get a value for y, isn't it? So what are the values of x and y called? These values for x and y are called the solutions of the linear equation. Okay, so these are called the solutions. The values for x and y are called the solutions of the equation. Solutions of the linear equation. Now, you'll be getting confused as whatever value we assign for x, we have a value for y, isn't it? So how many values we need to substitute and how many solutions we'll be able to get? So that is the answer for this. The solution for a linear equation, for a single linear equation in two variable, is infinite. Okay, so the solution is infinite or infinite. So how do we say it is infinite? Because just now I showed you whatever value we substitute for x, we get a corresponding value for y, isn't it? So we keep on substituting values for x, we'll be able to get the value for y, isn't it? So there are infinite solutions for a linear equation in two variable. If one linear equation is given, then there are infinitely many number of solutions for the equation. So as many solutions as we can substitute and we can get it. Do you understand? So that is what we understand from the linear equation in two variables and the solution it has. Okay, so from this, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, we'll be able to get the value for y when x is substituted some values. Okay, do you understand? So now, if at all I'm given a situation, what is the purpose of learning linear equations? I mean, what is the application or where it is applied? So just, we can't read in a chapter called linear equation, two variables and mark up all the concepts. No, it's not like that. So where do we apply the concept of linear equations in two variables? See, if you have two variables, you see two variables in an equation, and the two variables can be assigned as many number of values as you can. So the two variables represents two different situations. It can be two different situations, isn't it? Or two different conditions. It can be anything like that. So we can represent any real life application or real life situation through these equations. So let me tell you an example. The cost of a pen is twice, that is half more than twice half of a pencil. A cost of pen is half more than twice half more than its cost. Okay, then twice the cost of a pencil. Okay, so this is a condition we have, that is, cost of a pen is half more than its cost, then twice the cost of a pencil. Okay, so what does it mean? See, if I take the cost of pen to be y and cost of the pencil as x, so whatever we write in terms of some other, see, we write the cost of pen in terms of the cost of pencil, isn't it? So in terms of something has to be taken as x, we take it as x conventionally. We take it as s for our convenience, we take it as x, and the cost of pen as y. Now, what is the cost of pen? That is Y. So, what is Y? It is half more than its cost. Half more than its cost. That is, what is its cost? Its cost is Y and half more than what? More than the cost of the pencil. So, half more than the cost of pencil. Half more than its cost. Then twice the cost of pencil. Isn't it? So, twice the cost plus half of the pen's cost is the pen's cost. Isn't it? So, what does it mean? So, which means Y is equal to Y plus 4X divided by 2. So, what we get here? So, 2Y is equal to Y, which is equal to plus 4X. Therefore, 2y minus y is equal to 4x. So, y minus 4x is equal to 0. So, we get y minus 4x is equal to 0. This is the equation. This is a required equation in two variables. So, y minus 4x is equal to 0 is the required equation in two variables. Linear equation in two variables. So, we can substitute the values for x and y. So that this condition is satisfied, the given sign. So I have given some condition. For example, you can practice as many as statements and make them converted into equations, and you can solve them too. So you can put as many number of when x is 1 rupee, when x is 1, see cost of pencil is 1, then what is y? Y is equal to 4, isn't it? So 4 into 1 is 4, therefore y is equal to 4. So y is equal to 4 is the cost of pen, and if x is equal to 1, that is pencil is 1 rupee, then cost of pen is 4 rupees. So that is how we get for each and every value of x. If cost of pencil is 2 rupees, then the cost of pen will be y is equal to 8 rupees. So that way we will be able to find out as many number of values as the as it is assigned to each and every x or y for each and every variable. Okay, so that is how we can transform the given sentence, or we transform the given situation or the given condition to linear equations in two variables. So this is for just one equation in two variables. Okay, I've said one. If at all you have one equation in two variables, there are infinitely many number of solutions, I said. So what about if there are two equations? If there are two equations in linear two variables, like 2x plus 3y is equal to 4 and 3x plus 4y is equal to 6, some equations. So this equation, so let us say that x be some cost of mangoes and y be some cost of oranges, and you are given with a condition like this. See, 2 kg of mangoes and 3 kg of oranges is for some 400 rupees or 4000 rupees, like that. Like way 3 kg of mangoes and 4 kg of oranges cost something like that. So if you have equations like this, if you have two equations like this which carries two variables or which carries two conditions each, then what happens is, if you solve these two equations, we'll go into solving later on, but when you solve these two equations, you will be having one particular solution, that is only one value for x and y which satisfy both the equations. So if at all one equation is given in two variables, you have infinitely many number of solutions. But when you are given with two equations, that is two linear equations in two variables, and if you solve them, you will be getting only one set of point x and y. Only one set of point x and y, which exactly satisfies both the equations, that you have to note. So why I am telling you at this point of time is, you need to find the difference between one equation in two variables and if there are two equations in two variables. Do you understand? So why, if only one equation is given in two variables, it has many number of solutions. It has infinitely many number of solutions. Now, in case we are depicting the given linear equation in two variables, in terms of graph. That is, we need to visually represent the linear equation in two variables. So how do we do this? We can do this by either by number line. See, either by number line we can do it, like ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This is your general format. And first bring by, find out what is y, that is keep y as it is, and bring ax plus c to this side, then y is equal to minus ax plus c divided by b. So this will be your y, value for y, isn't it? So for each and every value for x, if I substitute 0 here, y will be minus c by b first, isn't it? Then when I substitute 1 here, y will be minus of a plus c by b, isn't it? So you can substitute any number of values for x and you will get the corresponding value for y. So find out the values for y and plot it in the number line. So that is one type of, for x is equal to this, what is y? That is one type of visual representation. The other one is graphically representing the equation. Linear equation in two variables can be graphically represented. So how do we represent graphically? So this is how we find out y. See, y, I said that is minus of ax plus c by b, isn't it? So this is how we find, this is the algorithm actually. Algorithm to plot the graph of a linear equation in two variables. Find the value for y by bringing all the terms to the right side, assign as many values as you can for x and substitute the values for x and find the value for y. And then plot the, make the tabular column with x and y values and then move on to plot the graph. Now we'll see for the equation 2x plus 3y is equal to 5. So let us take 2x plus 3y is equal to 5. Now I substitute, make a tabular column for x and y. I just substitute x is equal to 0 first. So when x is equal to 0, what is 3? What is the value for y? Y is equal to 3y is equal to. So let us take 6 to be convenient. We have whole numbers here. And so we don't want to mix up with the rational numbers or fractions. So when 2x, x is equal to 0, what is y? 2 into 0 plus 3y is equal to 6. So 3y is equal to 6, or y is equal to 2. So y is equal to 2. When x is equal to 1, what do we have? When x is equal to 1, okay, we have 2. Let us take 2. When x is equal to 2, 6 minus 4 becomes 2 again, isn't it? It's a fraction again. So let us take, okay, let us take 1 again. So if 2x, that is 2 into 1 plus 3y is equal to 6, and 3y is equal to 6 minus 2, that is 4. Or y is equal to 4 by 3. What is 4 by 3? 1 by 3. Okay, 1 by 3, let it be like that. So 1 by 3. And when y is 0, what is when y is 0? 2x is equal to 6, isn't it? We can substitute y also. So when y is equal to 0, 2x is equal to 6, or x is equal to 3. So x is equal to 3. So these are the points we get. Actually, we can substitute x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. We can have just two values and we can draw the, and we can plot the graph. But I have drawn you the intermediate point. I have given you the intermediate point too. Now let us draw the graph here. If you do it in a graph paper, it will be more convenient for you to see, for you to mark and join the points. Now this is your x-axis and y-axis as you have studied in coordinate geometry. Recollect it. How we plot points, isn't it? The same thing we are going to do. Since there are no negative values here, but I just plot them. See, first point is 0 and 2. I've told you how to plot the points. We have done that in coordinate geometry last chapter. We have done that. So for x is equal to 0, see x is 0 here and y is 2 here. So this is your first point, 0, 2. Abscissa is 2 and ordinate is, abscissa is 0 and ordinate is 2, isn't it? So the next point is 1 and 1 by 3, x is 1. So 1 by 3 somewhere comes to this place. So So this is 1, 1 by 3. Okay, now what is the third 3 and 0, where 3 is here and 0 y-axis, it's on the x-axis. 3 comma 0 lies on the x-axis, whereas 0 comma 2 lies on the y-axis. Okay, now just join all the points. So it is enough if you have just 2 points, but I've done with another point, so just for our convenience to join the points, nothing more than that. So I've joined the points. See, what did I get? A straight line. Okay, so you can try for as much linear equations as possible. You can practice them. We'll get a what we infer from this, we get a straight line. That is, a linear equation represents a straight line in the graph. So that you need to understand. So it represents a straight line. See, it represents a straight line in the graph. Okay, so linear equations represent straight line in the graph. When x is equal to, likewise, when x is equal to 0 here, so 3y is equal to 6 and y is equal to 2, I said. So y is equal to 2 here. So when x is equal to 0, the equation represents the y-axis. Isn't it? When x is equal to 0, you understand? There are points only in y and there are no points in x. So it represents the y-axis. So for y-axis, the linear equation is x is equal to 0. Likewise, when y is equal to 0, it represents the points on the x-axis and there is no point to the y-axis. So it represents, when y is equal to 0, it represents x-axis. So the linear equation for x-axis is y is equal to 0 and the linear equation for y-axis is x is equal to 0. We know that. Okay, from this we infer all these things. Okay, so likewise we have studied even before, when I draw a straight line like this. That is a line parallel to y-axis. A line parallel to y-axis is represented by what? See, in what point I have drawn here? This is x-axis, and in at x is equal to minus 2 I have drawn here parallel line. Like that, I have from y x is equal to minus 1, I draw another line parallel to y-axis, and that represents x is equal to minus 1 line, isn't it? So both these lines have points in x-axis. See, points in x-axis is constant. X is equal to minus 2 is constant. Y picks various values. If I plot a point here, I have minus 2 comma 1, isn't it? When I plot a point here, I have minus 2 comma 2, isn't it? So minus 2 remains constant here. So what does it mean? X is a constant, that is x is equal to minus 2. X is equal to minus 2 is a, see, x is equal to minus 2 is a linear equation for what? For a line parallel to y-axis. That you should remember. X is equal to k, or x is equal to some constant, x is equal to k is the generalized form of linear equation for a line parallel to y-axis. Likewise, if I draw, see, like this, that is y is equal to minus 1. This is y is equal to minus 1 line. And if I draw a line like this, this is y is equal to minus 3. So what does it imply? I can have any number of, if I mark a point here, it represents x 1 comma minus 1. Here, 2 comma minus 1. Here, 3 comma minus 1. Here, 4 comma minus 1. So the minus 1 remains constant. That is, the value for y remains constant, whereas x takes many number of values. So y is equal to some constant. Y is equal to k represents, y is equal to k represents a line parallel to x-axis. Okay, this is just a recap of what we did in the last chapter, but we are doing it with the graphical representation and we are studying it in relation to the linear equations. So this is also a linear equation, but these are with only one variable. Now, how to convert the one variable to two variables? We are doing with linear equations in two variables, isn't it? So we need two variables. So how to convert them? So if I say x is equal to some constant, so if I say x is equal to 2, this represents a line parallel to y-axis, isn't it? So x is equal to 2 here, if I draw a line here, x is equal to 2, the 2 point remains constant, x is equal to 2 point remains constant throughout the line. So that is a line parallel to y-axis. Now how do I convert this equation to linear equation on two variables? So I have x is equal to 2 here, so I bring this 2 to this side. Even then it becomes only linear equation in one variable. So x plus 0y minus 2 is equal to 0 is my required linear equation in two variables. You understand? Likewise, if I write y is equal to 5, this is y is equal to some constant, that is, it represents the line parallel to x-axis. This is x-axis and the line parallel to x-axis, that is, at y is equal to 5, we draw a line. There y is equal to 5 remains constant, whereas x takes many values, isn't it? So that is a line parallel to x-axis. And how do we rewrite this with two variables? There is no x, there is no x term here, isn't it? So 0x plus y minus 5 is equal to 0 becomes a linear equation in two variables. So we convert single variable equations to two variable equation like this. Okay, do I understand? So this is the introduction part for the linear equations in two variables. And we'll be moving on to doing more sums regarding linear equations in two variables. How do we solve them? How do we get the solution for linear equations? Both graphically and theoretically we'll be seeing. And we'll be seeing some situations and conditions which we'll be converting them into linear equations, and we'll be getting the solutions for them. Okay, so let's see all those problems and exercises in the next class. Until then, it's bye from Anu for MaxPool.1. Thank you.